My name is Memphis, Tennessee.
Mephiles the Dark, the devil himself of the Sonic the Hedgehog series. This has got to be one of the strangest characters in the entire franchise. He was created for the sole purpose of being the grand villain for Sonic 06's ambitious story. It's no wonder Mephiles has become such a strangely iconic Sonic villain. Well, maybe just iconic for us diehard fans and 06 lovers, but ever since his initial debut, he's become a heavily underused character. But I'd say his status as one of the strongest foes Sonic has ever faced is entirely justified, and I'm here to give you my opinion why. Let's explore from a narrative and storytelling standpoint on how exactly Mephiles the Dark is such a fantastic villain, not only for the Sonic series, but as a villain, period. This is Mephiles the Dark, a necessary evil. So what exactly makes Mephiles so special, let alone a great villain? Why, the same thing as any other timeless villain, the effect he has on the heroes. I've been very vocal about how weak and, let's face it, non-existent the conflict between Sonic and Mephiles is, but I've always praised Mephiles' interactions with Shadow and Silver. As the saying goes, a hero is only as great as his villain, and there's a reason that 06 Shadow is the best interpretation of the character in the games. But before I get ahead of myself, what exactly makes a great villain? Well, there's a variety of answers to such a question. On the one hand, we have a sympathetic villain. People who turn to the dark side for tragic and above all else, relatable reasons. A sympathetic villain can be as simply real as abusive parents or not having a stable, safe home life. Or they can be as extreme as eliminating half of the universe, all in an effort to, ironically, save it. You can sympathize with the wrongdoer in both situations because their circumstances are either relatable or at least their goals are understandable. And then on the other hand, we have my personal favorite villain archetype, monsters. These are your Jokers, your Ultrons, and Freezes of fiction. These characters want simple things. They want power or chaos, or sometimes they want nothing more than, well, nothingness. They are never relatable, let alone redeemable, because that's not in their nature. And that's often why they're so entertaining. Everything they say is so twisted. Everything they say could just as easily be a lie as it is the truth. It keeps you guessing. And if they aren't entertaining you with their wit, then they often leave you awestruck at their power by making you realize just how quickly they can annihilate our heroes. And in case it wasn't obvious, Mephiles is such a monster. So let's examine just what makes him such a fantastic antagonist, especially in Sonic 06. But back to the whole great villain makes a great hero thing I was talking about earlier. Let's talk about how Mephiles deals with Shadow and Silver in 06. Shadow the Hedgehog is at a pretty stable point in his life during Sonic 06. But it's when he encounters Mephiles that things get out of hand. Mephiles forces Shadow to deal with a question. Should he trust Mephiles whenever he describes of humanity's certain betrayal of Shadow? Should he instead join in Mephiles' crusade against humanity for revenge? Well, Shadow states quite clearly in their first interaction he wants nothing to do with it. However, it's clear to see in the famous Team Dark cutscene that the news made Shadow grow distant. He doesn't want to get his team involved on this mission, but with Rouge's convincing, he snaps out of it. Even to the last moment of their battle, Mephiles tells Shadow how strong and powerful he is. After all, Mephiles did steal his abilities, and kept trying to abuse Shadow's power for his own personal gain, using the sweet, sweet temptation of revenge. On the other hand, we have Silver. Silver, as we all know, is a young, naive boy in Sonic 06, which Mephiles takes full advantage of manipulating. While Mephiles went to get his revenge against Shadow, he led Silver on a mission to fulfill Mephiles' greatest desire, all while convincing Silver it was for the future's safety of all things. And whenever Silver does question the legitimacy of Mephiles' claims, Mephiles outright denies Silver of the information, telling him that if this isn't carried out properly, his future will be doomed forever. What sets Mephiles apart from other Sonic villains is his intellect. Against every mainline Sonic character, he stayed in the shadows, reaping the rewards of the strings he pulled. He never once encountered Sonic, which from a narrative perspective is extremely weak, but from a villain's perspective, it's an extremely smart move. And after Shadow's refusal of allegiance and Silver's turn to the good, he had them both so preoccupied that he was able to reveal his master plan and fulfill his desires as a great success. Let's not mince words here. Mephiles the Dark is the sole individual to ever kill Sonic the Hedgehog in the mainline games. With an attack as underhanded as the schemes that led him to this forever iconic moment that is the death of Sonic. He did as he set out to do, and became Solaris once more, and the only reason he lost was a lack of power in his final form as Solaris. Debatably, Mephiles was in fact too strong and cunning for the heroes to defeat without a major power boost in the form of brute force using the Chaos Emeralds in their super forms. These weaves of manipulation, the lies and half-truths, are perfectly fitting for the character. Although I did joke about it earlier, it's clear to see that the influence for Mephiles is, obviously, Mephistopheles. Mephistopheles is a devil-like creature in German folklore. This is most obviously shown through Mephiles' actions throughout the story. A liar and deceiver, tricking others for his own personal gains, similar to the classic Garden of Eden story. But that's not where the demonic parallels stop. Mephiles the Dark's design is heavily influenced by demonic imagery. His eyes are serpent-like, with a narrow pupil surrounded by seemingly bloodshot eyes. His body, in the form of shadow, a representation of his cunning and power, along with his final form being truly wild, his evil self overtaking shadow and corrupting it. His constant association with the dark purple fog shows an obvious air of mystery. The bones on his knuckles give off the feeling of death and devastation, similar to that of DC Comics' very own Doomsday. And that's not even to mention his theme song, by far one of the most cinematic and iconic tracks in the entire Sonic the Hedgehog franchise, and definitely a standout of the 06 OST. It's soft, scary, somber piano, trickling in as the song progresses. Its very melody invokes a feeling of torture, as if slow nails on a chalkboard just kept scratching and they never quite stopped. But once the orchestra kicks in, the feeling ramps up. It starts becoming less of torture and more of a battle, more of a cry for the heroes, more of a hope, a light in the tunnel, which is further exuded in the finale of the piece, which is a grand, uplifting orchestra, rising to the challenge and exceeding all of its limits. It is truly just a phenomenal piece of music and a great theme for Mephiles the Dark, and an awesome piece of music for the 06 soundtrack. And let us not mention Mephiles being brought to life in the game. Dan Green's performance is surprisingly fantastic. It's quite obvious if you know that he voices Knuckles that he's also Mephiles, but that doesn't take away from the performance. His air of mystery in his voice, his seemingly soft, constant rage, yet calm, cool collectedness. It's a voice with plenty of nuance in its emotion, and you can really tell that whenever he gets angry, you feel his presence. Honestly, Dan Green just truly brings Mephiles the Dark to life on screen. And as far as his animations go, although it's mainly the same thing as everyone else in 06, his body movement is slightly different. He moves a lot slower, a lot more angelically, you might even say, often taking positions like he's on a cross, religious imagery. And that makes total sense considering, well, he technically is a god. With all the things from the Dark Ages Sega has basically just wiped from the face of the earth, Mephiles is definitely the one that I'd say needs to come back the most. With all of the theories about whether he's connected to the Time Eater or not, or how he could or could not have been in Forces before its release, there's definitely a clear fan demand for this character, and I think it's a very understandable thing why. I mean, he's one of the most iconic villains in the entire franchise, he's the one character to kill Sonic the Hedgehog, and his presence was felt upon any player of 06's. But even if that's not the case and we never see Mephiles again outside of maybe another mobile game or something like that, well then all I can really do is hope and pray that Sega takes what worked with Mephiles the Dark and put it into a new character, into a new game, and do their best to either match his presence, or, even better, exceed it. Characters, specifically villains, such as Mephiles the Dark, have become a rarity in the Sonic series. His unflinching evil and merciless nature are hardly ever seen in current titles' villains. Zavok is hardly a presence, let alone a character. Infinite only has his looks going for him, and Eggman is always a treat, but he doesn't count. We all know he's great. The fact of the matter is, Mephiles is the single best Sonic villain to ever grace the series in my opinion. His motivations are simple yet intriguing. His moveset is diverse and has led to some of the greatest action scenes in any Sonic game to date. And lastly, of course, his cunning mind and constantly lying attitude make him an extremely entertaining villain that you simply can't help but watch. And ladies and gentlemen, that is why Mephiles the Dark is a necessary evil.